everybody. I'm having my blood pressure taken. This is the third of three tries, and I think they're just going to take the average. My average is 117 over 80. Now you can see I am wearing one of my corsets, not too tightly, but now we're doing the third of three once again. Now it's 122 over 88. Okay, everybody, in case you didn't know already, this video is going to be about corsets and its effect on blood pressure. So first of all, how does blood pressure work? Well, it works the same way as any other type of fluid pressure. For those of you who have taken physics, you know that pressure is related to the volume of the fluid actually passing through, the viscosity of the fluid, the capacity of the tube that it's actually flowing through, etc. So what does this mean for the body? Imagine if this straw was a blood vessel, like an artery or something in your body. Then to get a certain amount of volume through this straw, you have to use a certain amount of pressure. But if you have, you know, gunked up arteries from plaques and everything, that means the capacity or the inside circumference of this is going to be smaller, like this one. This is about half the width of the bigger one. I don't know if you can see on the camera. But what this means is that your heart has to pump harder to get the same volume of fluid through. And this is what high blood pressure is. So in February of 1989, a publication was released in the Journal of Strength and Conditioning Research by Hunter et al. And it was called The Effects of a Weight Training Belt on Blood Pressure During Exercise. And it showed that if a person was wearing a tight waist training belt around their waistline while they were doing resistance training or aerobic work, it would actually increase their blood pressure about between 6 and 15%, depending on the person and depending on how vigorous this exercise was. But I noticed that, you know, I feel my heart pounding a little harder whenever I'm wearing a very tight corset. And so that's why I decided to try and check out my own blood pressure. And as you can see in the beginning of this video, it showed that my blood pressure was increased about 10%. So this not only applies to weight training belts tightly around a waistline, it also applies to corsets, even if you're at rest. If you think about it, it makes sense, because if you think about a corset restricting the blood vessels in your core of the body, then your heart has to use more pressure to squeeze blood through that area down to your legs and back up from your legs back up to the heart. So let's consider this as a two-part process. The first part is, you know, first donning the corset and your circulatory system hasn't quite responded yet, and then the second part is when your circulatory system responds. So let's consider the first part, when you first put your corset on. What happens is everything is affected by gravity, including the blood in your body. This is why you usually, if you're standing up, you have greater blood pressure in your lower torso and your legs than you do in your head. This is normal. When you put a corset on, this is more so the case. So when you have blood going down to your legs, this is fairly easy, but it has greater difficulty coming back up. One way that your body gets around this is by having the one-way valves, which helps the blood get pushed up, but it can't let the blood backflow. When you become older, these valves become weaker, and that's why a lot of older women have varicose veins and swollen ankles and feet, because the blood is starting to pool down in the lower regions of their bodies. But you can help this by wearing compression stockings, which basically works by helping the blood get pushed back up into the torso. So a lot of people think that in the past, a lot of women who wore corsets fainted because of a lack of oxygen and they couldn't breathe, but this is only partially the case. Another reason for fainting is simply having not enough blood in the brain. So if a woman has very low blood pressure to begin with, and then they don a corset very, very tightly, which increases the blood pressure in the lower part of their bodies and decreases the pressure in the upper part of their bodies, that means that their brain is not getting enough blood pressure, which translates to not enough oxygen in their brains. So what do? They faint. What happens when you faint? Your body crumples. They go from vertical to horizontal, and this equalizes the blood pressure throughout the body. So relatively speaking, in the feet, the blood pressure is lower. In the head, the blood pressure is higher. The blood flow increases in the brain, and you regain consciousness. Now let's consider the second part, where your body reacts and adjusts to the tightness of your corset. If you have a strong, healthy circulatory system, then your heart is able to beat harder and with more pressure to get the blood through the tightness of the corset down into the legs and have it come back up again. But your body is... It can only adjust the blood pressure in one part of the body so well. So you can't increase the pressure in one part of your body without affecting other parts of your body as well. So the blood pressure everywhere else is increased, including in your head, your arms, your upper torso, everywhere. So have you ever heard the myth that a woman shouldn't get angry or upset lest she get a nosebleed? Well, this has a little bit of truth to it, because what happens when you become angry, upset, scared, this activates the fight or flight response in your body. And this increases the blood pressure in your body to prepare the body to either, you know, run away or fight against your enemy. So if you have weak blood vessel walls anywhere in your body, or very thin blood vessel walls, then the increase in pressure is going to make those walls break. Imagine if you took like a cardboard tube or something. If you redirected a stream from a tap, for instance, using a cardboard tube, that wouldn't be a problem. But if you were, for instance, to redirect the high pressure stream from a fireman's hose using a cardboard tube, what would happen? It would break apart, right? It can't handle that much pressure. And your veins and your arteries, the walls there can't handle that much pressure as well over time. So if this happens in the very fine blood vessels of the nose, what happens if you get upset is you get a nosebleed. If this happens in your brain, this is what causes a stroke. So like I had proven in the beginning of this video, a corset, even lightly laced, can increase your blood pressure somewhat. To what degree, this will change for each person. But I thought it was an area of importance to touch on, because if you are a more mature person considering starting corseting, and or if you have a predisposition to hypertension, then you must approach waist training with caution. So that's all for this video. I hope you have a very safe holidays. Don't drink and drive. Remember family first, and I will talk to you next time. Bye.